And the two? The board of governors, the town of Haven, the public, the investigations, and the organization, the sponsors.
So, our paper is about the protocol for finding a viable and cost-effective solution for city street lights. Was contacted exceptionally myself by Mr. Van Gogh's God, and yes, and the others, so I just want to see those Venus lovers. We are all part of Reform WB LLC. WB was founded in 1986, and is one of the biggest ICT companies in Western Greece and the Portuguese. And we specialize in offering financial, data management, business intelligence, and consulting services to public authorities all over Greece. So, why efficiency lighting management? Energy efficiency has gained a significant role in ensuring a safe, reliable, cost-effective, and sustainable energy system for the future. And why street lighting in particular? It is one of the key areas for investment in the European Union. It deals with electricity consumption and maintenance cost reduction, phasing out environmental accounting technologies, and the achievement of better control of the street lighting environment. There are currently numerous cities implementing energy efficient street lighting projects, mostly those involved in the covenant of mayors. However, sometimes local administrations fail to choose a suitable street light solution, mostly due to lack of proper feasibility, environmental impact, and exterior lighting studies, as well as lack of proper funding. The above result sometimes in overpriced projects and not needed large scale interventions. In a Greek city, street light electricity consumption usually represents circa 24% of its total expenses, and since it's contributory, it is covered by citizen taxes. So, the challenge is that cities need to abide by the EU set energy savings target, and also take into consideration the fragile social structure, not only in Greece, but also in other developed countries in the EU. Our protocol consists of four procedures. The first one deals with the city's energy data analysis. The second one with the exterior lighting condition study. The third one with points to locate points of intervention using business intelligence tools. And finally, the energy consumption and carbon emissions reduction goal setting and observable. The result of our protocol is the energy efficient street light management tailored to the city's needs in a cost-effective way. The first procedure consists of two steps. The first step, we analyze the energy consumption data. Electricity providers are obliged to grant the city access to its own energy consumption data, and they are categorized per use, for example, power boxes, municipal building electricity meters, street lighting electricity meters, etc. The analysis of the data can be done using data mining, data processing, and data visualization software. The result of this step is a list of electricity meters that burden the city budget the most, as well as the energy theft cases that exist within the city limits. Energy theft detection can be done by observing electricity meters with relatively unknowable behavior to the meters' median behavior of the same category. And the expensive electricity meters can be done by cross-checking with the tax services records in order to detect mistaken database entries and calculation of the loss per year city tax income. The second step deals with the mapping of the streetlight network. In other words, mapping the city's power boxes, street lights, lamps per street light, their characteristics, and the connecting lines between the above. The Technical Chamber of Greece suggests a really wide range of characteristics to be registered, and the data collection can be made using commercially available mapping software. The result is a geographic information system, GIS for short, where data is combined of both steps, and the city administration is aware of its current street light equipment available and the equipment's energy consumption profile. The second procedure deals with the implementation of the ISO EN 13201 standard for external lighting. The city streets are strictly categorized into lighting classes, and each lighting class is indicative of the geographic and operating features of a street. We describe the special lighting features and adaptive lighting features for each class, leading to a normal and adaptive lighting classes. Each city street should be assigned to a single normal lighting class, whereas the option will be assigned to one or more adaptive lighting classes. Then photometric analysis for its lighting classes conducted using free available software. The result of this procedure is a combination of the above data with those that occurred for the first procedure, leading to the extraction of the minimum features of potential new street lighting system should offer in order to abide by the ISO standard. The estimation also of best targets to be achieved is made available through the calculation of cost and environmental efficiency indices, such as the energy consumption reduction percentage, cost reduction in sand per year, return investment rate, and carbon emission reduction in tons per year. Well, so far, the first two procedures result in what every street in a city needs and what will the cost and outcome of a possible optimal integration in any city street may be. They do not take into account the local climate and per day sun hours, and they could result in wide, large-scale light replacement project that will deal with the city's needs in an optimal way. However, projects with optimal results require extensive funding and do not take into consideration the economic and social challenges the city may face, particularly in Greece and other financially struggling countries. So, we propose in the third procedure the minimization of interventions so that the total cost can meet the city's budget. In other words, we locate the points of intervention by exploiting the findings of the first procedure. We create project implementation scenarios and recalculate the indices for all scenarios. And we take into account the local climate and hours of sunlight in a particular city. The above can be done using commercially available business intelligence software. The result of this procedure is less costly interventions, yet still the targets set by the Covenant of Mayors and the Energy Efficiency Directive can be met. For example, a single one, a city administration could decide on implementing a full-scale street light replacement project in the main street of the city limits, but only install astronomically programmable power switches and power boxes in the outskirts of the city. The last procedure deals with the city administration selecting the scenario and all set of scenarios to be implemented. It is about the commitment of funds, the procurement and the assignment of the contracts, the re-estimation of taxes that citizens pay per year given the reinvestment rate of the proposed projects, and planning the next projects to be implemented in order to meet the targets set by the EU. The result of this procedure is a detailed financial and social analysis so that the administration can both ensure the contractors stay up to the city's expectations and the environmental and cost reduction costs are met. In case any contractor falls short of what the city expects, there will be legal and financial penalty clauses in order for the city budget to stay on track. The above can be done by using commercially available business intelligence software. A case study. We implemented this protocol partially in a medium-sized Greek city. The city budget for 2016 was 47.4 million euros. We initiated the protocol in July 2016. Procedure 2 was finalized last September, and Procedure 3 is set to begin next January. Procedure 1 result, we found out more than 12,000 data records were mistaken, leading to a loss of 1.1 million euros per year. We updated the mistaken records and led to a significant minimization of lost income per year down to 0.3 million euros. We detected 500 potential energy theft cases, of which 306 proved to be true. And the City Financial Council suggested a 15% reduction of the yearly imposed taxes in the city parts with a lower per capita income. Procedure to result. The city successfully implemented a full photometric study for its streetlight network, and an optimal streetlight replacement suggested that the energy consumption cost reduction would be at least 57%. To finish with, the advantages of our protocol is for first and foremost that the city can become fully aware of its current streetlight equipment available and its equipment's energy consumption profile. The city can easily design an energy and cost-efficient solution. It is easy to determine the goals to be achieved and the set of solutions most suitable to the city's needs. Electricity theft cases can be easily detected, and the loss per year income from mistaken database entries can be minimized. Thank you. respected speaker. The question will be all heard at the end of all the three sections. So I'm going to invite the second speaker, Professor Stamatiadis,